Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, there was an interesting tweet posted by Jonathan McDowell. It says, this is very interesting, official complaint sort of from China about having to maneuver the Chinese space station to avoid Starlinks. There was a tweet posted related to concerns about SpaceX's plan to build a new launch site, LC-49, at KSC. This tweet says, SpaceX's proposed launch site draws concern about environmental damage, Playa Linda Beach Road. There was a Space News article posted about an issue with one of the satellites for the Transport of Free rideshare mission scheduled in January. It says a Sherpa tug has been removed from an upcoming SpaceX rideshare mission after its propulsion system developed a leak, forcing spaceflight to find new rides for 10 CubeSats. There was an article posted saying the astronauts launching with the first private crewed mission to the International Space Station next year have cleared all their medical evaluations. These crew members will fly to the ISS on a Crew Dragon capsule. Heading over to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital launch mount. Here's a view of the progress on the construction of the wide bay in the production yard. Here's a view of the stairs being built behind the high bay. These unknown parts were spotted delivered at the production yard. There was a tweet posted by the FAA saying the FAA continues its programmatic environmental assessment for the proposed SpaceX Starship Super Heavy project in Boca Chica, Texas. The new target date for issuing the final PEA is February 28th. Musk was asked, when are we expecting the first orbital flight to happen next year? Is it still in January? He responded and said, FAA approval is the scheduled driver. Their latest update says end of February. Starship 20 has continued to wait on the pad and undergo preparations for its next static fire test. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, most of the dates are still obsolete. However, there is a closure scheduled for some possible testing today, Wednesday 29th, and tomorrow, Thursday 30th. Mary also posted a tweet saying that she had received an alert for a possible Starship 20 static fire test today. So hopefully today we will see Ship 20 once again fire her Raptor engines. As well as the cryogenic proof testing that Booster 4 did, it's also recently performed some igniter tests of its Raptor engines. Here's a great view of how the Raptor igniter tests looked like. Interestingly, the crane was moved over to the Booster 4 prototype. The super heavy Booster 7 section in the high bay was lifted to be stacked on another barrel section. Then it was lowered onto and stacked with the new ring stack in the high bay. To finish up today's video, we once again have a Starbase production diagram to take a look at thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.